Hail to you, our King. You alone are compassionate with our errors. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. One of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said, "What are you willing to give me if I hand him over to you?" They paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that time on he looked for an opportunity to hand him over. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, the disciples approached Jesus and said, "Where do you want us to prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He said, "Go into the city to a certain man and tell him, 'The teacher says my appointed time draws near. In your house I shall celebrate the Passover with my disciples.'" The disciples then did as Jesus had ordered and prepared the Passover. While it was evening, he reclined at table with the 12, and while they were eating, he said, "Amen, amen, amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me." Deeply distressed at this, they began to say to him one after another, "Surely it is not I, Lord." He said in reply, "He who has dipped his hand into the dish with me is the one who will betray me. The Son of Man indeed goes, as it is written of him, but woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would be better for that man if he had never been born." Then Judas, his betrayer, said in reply, "Surely it is not I, Rabbi." He answered, "You have said so." The Gospel of the Lord. My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Our Lord will speak those words very soon. In fact, St. Matthew records them 12 verses after the gospel that we have just heard for this Mass of Wednesday of Holy Week. And our Lord was sorrowful, his soul sorrowful unto death in his agony in the garden as an effect of the betrayal of Judas. It is the betrayal of Judas and of Adam and of you and me that produces this anguish in the soul of the God-man. When we consider and meditate upon the Passion this week, some things are acutely obvious to us. We see the scourging and the crowning with thorns and, of course, the nails, and the physical exhaustion that costs our Lord so dearly as he dies upon the cross. But equally, if not more painful for the Lord, was his anguish of soul. So I commend to you a wonderful sermon written by St. John Henry Newman called The Mental Sufferings of Christ in the Passion, which gives us a window into why Jesus was agonizing, why his soul was sorrowful unto death. What are the effects of sin? As St. Paul says, he who was not sin, he who did not know sin, became sin. In other words, he took on the sin of the world, and it produced this terrible consequence in our Lord's mind, heart, and soul. Now, in between the end of this gospel in Matthew 26, verse 25, and 12 verses later, when our Lord enters into his agony in the garden, something else takes place. And it is, as we know, one of the most remarkable moments in human history and in salvation history. In the space of those 12 verses, as recorded by the sacred writer, our Lord institutes the Eucharist. It is there that for the first time he gives himself, under the appearance of bread and wine, his body, blood, soul, and divinity to his disciples. And so it is at the Mass that we do two things. We remember the anguish of the Lord. We remember his passion. We remember what our betrayal cost him. But at the same time, we remember the generosity and the goodness of God as it's poured out to us during the Passion, which is the remedy and the healing of the betrayal. It is the gift of the Holy Eucharist. It is the gift of God himself to us. It is what makes it possible for us not only to be healed of the wounds of sin, but to be strengthened and to resolve with God's grace not to sin anymore and to live a life that is pleasing to Him. We meditate upon the passion of our Lord this week. We meditate on what it cost Him. And at the same time, we give thanks for what His passion has produced, the gift of the Holy Eucharist, which turns our souls now into something pleasing to the Lord and leads to our sanctification and, please God, our salvation. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.